So, what are we doing in this video? In today's video, we're only going to be looking at muscle cars, and what are the most modifiable muscle cars in GTA? So, I'm not going to show any Bennies or any arena war vehicle, just because it would just be full of Bennies cars, and the arena war vehicles are just the same thing really, it would just take up the whole list like the Bennies would. Let's get straight into the video. Okay, first on the list in 10th place is the Vapid Hustler. Now, the Vapid Hustler is only one of two hot rods in the game, competing with a hot knife. But the hot knife is definitely a lot cheaper. The Hustler actually costs 625,000. Now, the modifications you can put on it are really cool and obviously suited for the vehicle. You've got a lot of rust liveries, and I suggest, you know, you put on a matte color underneath so you don't get that shine with the rust. It just doesn't suit. So if you do put a rust livery on, make sure you go matte with the color scheme. What I like to do is put the salt livery on, and actually when it's in the snow, the salt livery actually looks really cool because it looks like your car's covered in snow, but it's actually salt. You have so many cool modifications, and yeah, it's not even a slow vehicle as well. And yeah, the cool thing is you can actually resemble it to the 32 Ford, which when you actually put it at the perfect spec, you can look, it nearly looks identical. Now, coming in 9th place, the Clique. Now, the Clique was free for a while, I think in 2019, but now it actually costs 909,000. The car has 45 different mods on it, and it's really cool because it comes with a lot of racing stripes. And yeah, this car is very good round track for the muscle car class. The modifications look super well. My favorite modification has to be like the belts on the boot and the hood. It just looks really cool. And you know, how many cars do you get like this? Well, I don't know, 50 sports cars. Like, you don't get many of those. You got the option to expose the bonnet, and you have a really clean engine bay. That's why I made it like a stance build, because you see those stance builds out there where they have such a clean engine bay, and it's just a show car. That's what I really love about this car, but I really prefer it to be, you know, a race car. That's what it's designed to be. That's what it is, and that's how it performs in GTA as well. Now, in 8th place, the Peyote Gasser. Now, I'm so surprised to see this vehicle at 805,000. Such a unique car for such a low price, you know. Bearing in mind, this ain't one of the first cars that came out in GTA. This actually came out in the Diamond Casino heist. And yeah, 805,000. The car has 57 individual mods, so that's a big jump from the last one, which was 45. And yeah, don't expect to obviously win any track races. This is a straight line car, and it wheelies very well. The best modification, I have to say, is, well, it's not really a modification because it comes stock like this, but the, you know, the chop down pipes or from the headers. There's no other vehicle that has that mod, and it looks really cool. And it looks like they went above and beyond for this car, even though it doesn't cost that much, and the proportions of it are way different to any other car. Now, the Vamos. The Vamos comes 7th place with 67 modifications. Now, the modifications on this are very surprising, like the wide body you can get on this, and then the twin turbos coming through the grille, and even the single turbo, the big single turbo that you get. It's very different. It's very just a custom build. You can make this car look like a full-out dragster. I like to keep mine a bit more low-key and more realistic. I did change it up for this video. I didn't really want to change my crew color, so I made sure I didn't touch that. I feel like this color really suits the car, and it's really cheap as well. 596,000. I mean, that's really cheap for a car that has so many modifications. And you guys have to drive this if you haven't already. If you've not driven any old muscle car in the game, especially with these newer ones that have a lot more power, then you have to drive it. The stiffness in the car, the agility in the car, like resembling a muscle car of that era. I really think GTA nailed it with this car, and it's got so much character to drive. I can't stress enough how different it feels to every other car. Now, in 6th place, with one more modification than the Vamos, 68 modifications, the Deviant. Now, the Deviant is definitely overlooked. I hardly ever see it, and it is probably because of the looks, and I must admit, it, you know, I know it's based off the Javelin, but it's just not the best looking muscle car in the game, in my opinion anyway. People may think it's the best looking car in the game, but that is also why I kind of like it as well. A lot of people don't drive this around. It's a rare car, and the price is 512,000. Again, a car with so many modifications and it's that cheap. I'm pretty sure you guys already know, you know, stuff like the Club and small cars like that have many modifications cost 1.1 million, And then you have these cars, which are actually reasonably priced. Now, my favorite modification has to be the supercharger. It's just, you know, half in, half out. I don't think I've ever seen any other car with that modification, like half the supercharger showing. It's very cool to see, and actually after this video, I think I'm going to drive this around a bit more. Now, the Drift Yosemite, not Yosemite Heller, Yosemite. I still get comments about that every time I say Yosemite. But anyway, a car that is probably not surprising, in fifth place comes the Drift Yosemite. And why I say not surprising, because literally in the picture on Southern San Andreas, you've got those exposed turbos and you've got a pre-modified car already, which, you know, makes a lot of sense. You can't go back to stock, obviously, but you can get a lot more crazier with all these builds. You've got so many liveries. And you know, you've got something that you'd probably see in Gymkhana. It's a very good job what GTA have done. Now, the normal Yosemite should be on this list with 78 modifications. It should be higher than this. But because I've already got the Drift Yosemite, I didn't want two Yosemites on the list. Hope you can understand that. 1.3 million if you don't have the trade price. Is it worth it? I don't think so, because it's not, you know, it's got drift in its name, but you can't do, you know, big drifts. You can only do small kind of street drifting. And yeah, once you've used it, you don't tend to use it again. Now, I think the Hellfire is most people's favorite on this list, and it is for a reason. There's loads of modifications on it. You can make it like near enough every single variant of Challengers, and the parts on it are from other cars. They're actually real car parts. You know, you've got like Camaro parts, you've got like Plymouth parts. You know, the modifications are like almost Easter eggs. And you know, I think people definitely prefer that rather than GTA making up their own parts. Even some games like Forza, where they have the generic splitter for every car. But with some cars in GTA, you have detail like this. Now, next up on the list is another Gauntlet. So it's a Gauntlet Classic. And this is another one of my favorites, actually. A car with variants that you also get from a variety of different muscle cars. You know, another one that you can actually go drag focused in. Many liveries on this vehicle. Yeah, this car is really self-explanatory of how cool it looks and how great it handles. Like I said, all these old muscle cars that are released recently are very good at interpreting how the car should handle. Okay, now coming in at number two, and a very recent new vehicle as well, the Beta Dukes. Now, very recent, very cheap, so affordable. Like, if we weren't doing this in rank of how many modifications, this would be a number one for best overall attraction to buy this vehicle. 378,000, that's really cheap. And it has 95 modifications. That is a lot of modifications, and it's very rare as well, because people see the old Dukes and they think, well, this is probably the same, but with a bit of damage. It's actually very different. You can get so many mods you could not get on the old Dukes. And one very appealing one is the twin turbos coming out of the hood. You can get so many different liveries on this. You can make it look rusty. You can make it look like an actual, you know, a beater. Or you can actually clean it up and make it look like the normal Dukes, but with all these modifications that you could never get on the other normal Dukes. And that's why I would rank this number one, but it's not number one. But what is number one is the Dominator GTX. Now, the Dominator GTX costs 725,000. And when I say this is number one in mods, it's number one quite far away. So we had number two, which was 95 mods. This car actually has 116 mods at number one. So if you're customizing this car for the first time, it's very overwhelming. You might just need like three or four of these cars to get different variants of mods on them. But at 725,000, it's very affordable. I think this whole muscle car series has actually been quite affordable. Now, if I do another series in these, which let me know if you do want to see more, I'm pretty sure we'll see like the prices of vehicles very high and not this affordable. So if you're looking to buy customized cars, you should definitely look down this list of muscle cars. That's it, everyone. Let me know if you want to see different ranges of cars. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.